But Kenny was making a whole lot of sense. Kenny Smith was making a whole lot of sense. And like I said, Kenny Smith was so underrated as a point guard in this league. He really was an effective point guard. And it's only when Rudy Tomjanovich took over as coach and they decided that they were going to go into Lajuan as first option on every play. And they basically set everybody else outside the three-point circle, you know, for him to kick it out, you know, if he couldn't, you know, do some kind of Akeem move, because nobody had moved to the hoop like Akeem from center position. But if he was always the first option, everybody else basically stood around the three-point circle waiting to get a kickback, you know, from our team. And that really took away a lot of Kenny Smith's ability to do the things that he could do. And pretty much relegated him into a three-point shooter. Kenny Smith had a whole lot much more game than that. You know, so, he's not really accorded the amount of props that I think he should have gotten. And before he came to the Rockets, he was with the Sacramento Kings, and they were just not a very good ball team. You know, so he really wasn't seen that much when he was really in his basketball playing prime. I think Kenny Smith, though, was one of the better guards in the league during his tenure. And everything I've heard him say, for the most part, since he's been out, since he's been through playing and on television, it's been pretty much on the money. But it's just, you know, in a way ironic to me that he gets more notoriety now as a commentator than he ever got as a reporter. I mean, I'm sorry, as a ball player. You know, he was a very good ball player. But he's got two rings, so, you know, we don't have to shed any tears for Kenny Smith. He had a great career, he's got two rings, and a whole lot of NBA ball players can't say that.